morning, dear students. Students, before I am going to start this lesson, now I am going to show you some pictures. You have to recognize it and just think the answer by yourself. Whose picture is this? Can you tell me? Yes, this is the picture of Mahatma Gandhi ji. Please, one more. Can you tell me who's this picture? Yes, Lal Bahadur Shastri. Students, can you guess who is this? Yes, of course, Rani Chennamma of Kittur. Do you know, students, which river is this? Yes, this is Talakaveri. It takes birth in Kodagu. So these pictures are related to our today's topic. So let's begin lesson 3, Kodagu, Kitturu, Tulunadu and Hyderabad, Karnataka. So today we are going to discuss the topic Kodagu and Kitturu. Now we will see Kodagu. After independence for a while, Kodagu remained as a separate state. In 1956, Kodagu was merged with Karnataka. In 1956, Kodagu was merged with Karnataka. Kodagu district lies on the slope of the Western Ghats, and most of the people in the district speak Kodava or Arabashi language. You know very well, students, River Kaveri is the lifeline of Karnataka. It takes birth at Talakaveri in Kodagu. A famous Nagarapane National Park is in Kodagu. Next we will see Haleri Dynasty. Haleri Dynasty is the most important dynasty that ruled in Kodagu. We can say this is the first dynasty that ruled in Kodagu in the beginning of 17th century. Veera Raja founded this dynasty. Later, Muthu Raja built Muthu Rajakeri and he made his capital. Muthu Rajakeri now become Madikeri. Next, Kodagu was ruled by Hyderali and Tipu Sultan during the second half of 18th century. During that time, King Veera Raja of Kodagu was a prisoner of Tipu Sultan. And after escaping from Tipu Sultan, Veera Raja regained his kingdom with the help of Britishers. Regained means again he took back his kingdom with the help of Britishers. After the death of Tipu Sultan, the kings of Kodagu and Mysuru remained in good terms. Next we will see Kodagu and British. British captured Kodagu in the year 1834 and they started to rule directly from Kodagu. That time they divided Kodagu by making Amarasurya, which was part of Kodagu and it is a part of Kenara district also. Now we will see the revolt of Amarasurya. Since the peasants of Amarasurya found it hard to bear the heavy burden of land tax. Peasant is farmer. They are facing a very difficult to pay the land tax. So they started to revolt against the British. What is their intention? Why they started to revolt against the British? Because it is very difficult to pay the land tax. So they started to revolt against the British. So they decided to drive out the British from Kodagu. The revolt which broke out in 1837. It is known as the Amarasulya Revolt. The rebels held at Sulya, Mangaluru, Kasaragodu for 13 days. Next we will see two outstanding sons of Kodagu. Kodagu is known outside India mainly on account of its illustrious son General K.M. Karyappa. K.M. Karyappa. K means Kodendra, M means Madappa Karyappa. Kodendra Madappa Karyappa. K.M. Karyappa. He was the first Indian general of the Indian army and also the chief of the Indian army, navy and air force of independent India. And he was the recipient of highest rank field marshal. And another great patriot of Kodagu was General K.S. Timmaya. General K.S. Timmaya. K means Kodendra, S means Subbaya and Timmaya. Kodendra, Subbaya, Timmaya. He brought the victory to the nation in the war between India and Pakistan. These are the two outstanding sons of Kodagu. Next concept is Kittur. If you heard the name Kittur, what you will remember? Yes, Rani Chennamma. She was the great queen of Kittur and she was the younger wife of Malla Sarja, the Desai of Kittur. Both Malla Sarja and his son died in the battle. So Rani Chennamma decided to adopt the boy Malla Sarja and started administering the Kittur. The collector of Darwad, Thackeray, objected the adoption as improper. He recommended the British government to take over the administration of Kittur. On hearing this, Chennamma became extremely angry. She opposed the British policy of suppressing Kittur and decided to fight with British. Thackeray with an army attacked Kittur. Chennamma led her army and fought valiantly and bravely. British army was shattered and Thackeray hit by a bullet and died in the battle. Rani Chennamma fought against the huge British army for 3 days. Some of the leader of Kittur betrayed her and joined with British. Thus, Kittur was defeated. Rani Chennamma was defeated in her last battle and captured by the British and imprisoned at Vailahongal. She continued to be in the prison for 5 years. The secret guiding and inspiring the people to carry on the freedom struggle. Next we will see Sangolli Rayanna. Sangolli Rayanna was a loyal follower of Rani Chennamma. Sangolli Rayanna was a loyal follower of Rani Chennamma. After the Chennamma's imprisonment, he assumed the leadership of Kittur province and organized an army. And he attacked British officers and looted their treasure. Rayanna was the frightening whim to the British. And British could not defeat him. They resorted to foul means. They bribed a few persons who turned traitors. They captured Rayanna by deceit and handed him over to the British. Soon Rayanna and his associates were hanged. After the death of Sangolli Rayanna, several others continued the revolt of Kittur. So dear students, in today's class we learnt about the Kodagu and Kitturu. Kodagu we learnt that so many things, the Kohalevi dynasty, the revolt of Amarasimha, two outstanding sons of Kodagu. In Kitturu we learnt a brave freedom fighter of Rani Chennamma and Sangolli Rayanna. Now I am going to ask you questions. Just think the answer by yourself. Which is the first important dynasty that ruled in Kodagu? Did you get the answer? Yes. Haliri dynasty is the first dynasty that ruled in Kodagu. Who is Sangolli Rayanna? Sangolli Rayanna was a loyal follower of Rani Chennamma. So dear student, watch the video properly and read the lesson well and understand it well. Thank you.